What's up from 50 States My Way? It's Ashley and Ryan, and we're here in Knoxville, Tennessee for state number 15. Our first stop is at Fort Dickerson Park with the quarry behind me. We're gonna see if we can find any trails to explore. Adventure awaits, and we can't wait to share it with you. Like, subscribe, and comment down below. Let's go take a hike here in Knoxville. Fort Dickerson. This federal work was a major factor in the defense of Knoxville against Lieutenant General Longstreet's assault in November 1863. The fort and neighboring hills were manned by the 2nd Brigade, 3rd Division, 23rd Corps, which repulsed by fire Wheeler's Cavalry Corps, advancing from Sweetwater and Maryville. As you can see, like, this is part of like South Knoxville right here. And Fort Dickerson, and then the park that surrounds it. So we're gonna go explore. We think we found a trail that is right by the quarry overlook. So we're gonna go check it out, see what we find. Who knows? So this is definitely a trail. It's obviously unpaved, but you can tell just the way it's cut, but this is definitely a hiking trail going around part of the quarry at Fort Dickerson. We're gonna go check out the fort in a little bit, but we definitely wanted to see what kind of city hiking we could find. Columbus has such beautiful metro parks, and that's one of the great things when going to different cities. Check out what's available and what might be off the beaten path. I mean, there's nobody here, so it's pretty cool.
Oh, okay.
Do you want to do a switchback and go down? Yeah, let's go down.
I think I have an idea.
It's a perfect day. You know, it's wet and rainy, but no, it's just damp. Yep. Right. I think
it is.
This might be the access point here. Just be careful of poison ivy. Check out that view. Wow. That's beautiful. Yeah, definitely don't get too close to the edge.
You can tell with the trees, because you don't want to climb
in. Yeah, it's definitely got some erosion going on. So this viewpoint that we found definitely appears to be the end of this unpaved trail. It wouldn't be safe to even attempt to go further with some of the erosion. Ryan's kind of checking it out, but yeah, if I have to climb through trees, that means that it's not a trail. So I'm gonna head back to the car and then probably head over to the fort and maybe find some more trails. Yeah, this trail was definitely worth popping onto. Found more trail. Some fence sections, but definitely marked. It's pretty.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, that'd be one help.
This other trail that we found, so it didn't end, it does keep going, and it, as I suspected from just looking at some of the maps, definitely goes around the quarry. It follows private property line, but there's fencing and, you know, do not enter signs. I mean, it's just, here's Ryan taking a picture of the view. Check it. just an incredible view of the quarry. It's a really nice trail. In the middle of Knoxville, in the middle of the city.
And then Tippy Saters, if you look straight ahead, there's their observation deck where we started out.
Oh yeah, that's where we were. So right there, if you follow my finger, that's where we started. And we've now come to exactly the other side. Huh, cool. It looks like we found one of the other parking areas to Fort Dickerson Park. And literally this one actually has a sign that says, hey, here's the trail. Where we were, we had to figure it out ourselves. So I think this actually goes all the way down to the quarry. So we're gonna keep following it. But yeah, look, trail. That's funny. Okay, so yeah, we were just on the Pit Viper Trail and we did it. So this up here is the Big Reach Trail, but I don't know how you would do that and not go onto the private property. Some railroad tracks down there. Spots to park your bike. Trash cans.
Civilization.
He's crazy. Does anybody want him? Does anybody want to take home Orion? He's, you know, take him home.
Yeah. Sour Patch
Yeah, he likes Sour Patch Kids and he's semi-housebroken. We found the actual, like, ground level of the quarry. And I think we found another trail that will take us back to where we came the opposite way. So really and truly, I think the trails do circle the quarry. You just have to find them. They're marked in this area, but we kind of just figured it out where we were. So let's follow this gravel path a minute. Where is it? Oh yeah, it's down here. Yeah. So in the summertime, people do, oh my gosh, look at this view. It's just so pretty. In the summertime, people do come here to swim. And this is the path that takes you to that area. So you can swim. I think you can kayak in this quarry. It's not overly large, but it definitely packs a punch. You know, in Columbus, we would call this a metro park. And again, there's nobody here. Absolutely nobody here. It's beautiful. So again, just for some wayfinding, right there, that's the overlook where we started. And we literally took the trail all the way down to here. So we're going to see if we can do a trail that goes up that way and makes the complete circle. And of course, Run 50 States My Way, I forgot to put my Garmin on. So I'm getting steps, but not GPS distance. So I'm doing this video also to prove that it happened. Because remember, if your watch didn't record it, it didn't happen. All right, it looks like here's where you can swim. So here's like the beach entrance. So we've made it down to the actual quarry beach. Absolutely beautiful here at Fort Dickerson Park in Knoxville. All right, we're on a new trail, heading the other side of the quarry to see if this takes us back to the car. And then we can say we've done the full quarry loop. So heading back up was much nicer coming down. Because we're in Knoxville and there's hills. We're in them hills. All right, it looks like we found the trailhead that takes us back up. So we're gonna follow it and hope it takes us back to the car. Really wish I had started my watch because I'm getting some good mileage at this city park. And again, it's literally just me and Ryan. I can't imagine how many people right now are at Great Smoky Mountains and it's just him and I. He's up there taking more pictures. I'm waiting for him. There's two paths. This one's going down. We're just gonna see what's down there, but we think we found this other trail that's marked that is what's gonna take us back up. But ever the curious Ryan, he wanted to see what was down here. Low bridge. Go. It's like a hidden grotto. Totally off the beaten path. Wonder if this takes you down to another access point to the quarry. And we were right. Right under the cliffs, another access point with two geese. Really pretty. I like this trail because you get to really be up close to the cliffs to see the carving from the quarry work. All right, we're now back on a different trail, heading up, hopefully, to our car. We're gonna find out. We've done this complete without maps, just exploring. Pretty awesome. So this trail seems to have a lot of switchbacks. It is taking us like a zigzaggy type path up the mountain. We either think it's going to take us back up to where the car is or to the actual old fort. We're not altogether sure, but we're definitely not by the quarry anymore. Where the other trail hugged the quarry, this one kind of takes you away from it. So don't know. You can't really get lost because we found a road, which is the, whew, and there's that up there.
No.
No, yeah, absolutely not.
I know where it's going to take us.
But we think that this road here is the road that you would drive on to get to the remnants of the old fort. So because we're alongside of it,
both to the quarry and to the fort.
Yeah. And so. I mean, civilization is right there. We don't exactly know where our car is at the moment. We think we have an idea.
That's true too.
But I did start my watch a ways back and I did just hit a mile, but Ryan round trip so far.
Round trip, including the other trails. Right now, I have 2.6.
All right, so 2.6. So for those who don't think that Fort Dickerson is a good place to hike, you really should check it out. We're getting a lot of mileage in. And, oh, hey, that's the University of Tennessee. Huh. That's what that is. Those buildings?
Yeah.
Because that's the football stadium. Oh, wow. All right, well, we found the fighting dogs, I think is what they are. They're like
volunteers.
Okay, well, their mascot's a dog. That I know. So.
Yeah, so you're right near housing, Railroad Tracks and Road. So
yeah, I mean.
Help is nearby.
Exactly.
Enter the road, so.
Which is why we're kind of okay being that we don't really have a map. We have a good sense that we're in nature, but we're not disconnected. Still bring water
and snacks,
though. I mean, we have our packs. And Ryan did want me to mention to everybody that there are no bathrooms that we have found so far. So be warned. Be warned. Be aware. Have not seen a potty. All right, we'll check in with you guys in a little bit. This just talks about here that there is a Knox bike racing, and looks like they just had one recently, but that kind of makes sense because of how these trails are cut. It would be really fun to mountain bike. especially right here with all these switchbacks. I want to document it, Run 50 States My Way. Ryan says he owes me a massage like no other. because now we're kind of like in a meadow. We got off the switchbacks and we're following the electrical towers, essentially, to see if that leads us to our car. We know that there was a road right near us still, because we just saw a truck, but figuring out how to get back to where we started has been a definite mega adventure. And we are over 3 miles. So we were thinking today to go to Iams Nature Preserve, which also has a quarry. We might not, because we didn't think that Fort Dickerson was this big, but there is definitely a lot to see and explore here. And we're definitely getting our hike on. So.
Yeah, there's the quarry right there.
Oh, hey, we found the quarry. Okay. I have hope. I have hope. So the switchback trail that we were on is this, trial and error. We got off of it and basically cut through, like I said, the meadow underneath the towers. And there's our car. So we found it. We did it. And most importantly, we just explored and checked everything out. So now we are going to take the car, I think, to see where Fort Dickerson ruins are. So we know we passed it.
So 50 Staters, I'm taking a guess if you do all the switchbacks and everything else. And for those locals that probably truly know this, I'm guessing probably over 4 miles worth of trail for certain that you're going to go through first. Absolutely. So I'm just saying, be prepared for a hike.
And it really was a great hike. Being down by the quarry, seeing that, you know, we never truly felt lost. We had a good sense that we were going in a circle, which was, you know, what the quarry is. We just kept to the trails in front of us. And yeah, I know I've said it multiple times in this video, and I can't echo it enough. You know, a lot of people go down to the Great Smoky Mountains and use Knoxville as kind of a jumping off point. And it's the most visited, most popular national park in the national park system. This time of year, because it's March, end of March, beginning of April, schools are on spring break. It's gonna be packed. We were out here today and nobody was out here. We had this park completely to ourselves and we had an absolute blast. So if you're in Knoxville, especially if you're here for the Covenant Knoxville Marathon like we are, you definitely got to check out Fort Dickerson because it is a great place in the middle of the city. With that, we're going to go see if we can find a fort. So here's that road we kept talking about. There's one of the biking trails. And right up here at the top of the mountain, literally, is Fort Dickerson, Civil War earthen fort. What's left of it, at least. And again, down there, that is all the University of Tennessee along the Tennessee River.
I think the trail that we took
would
have led us up here.
It would have. If we had stayed on the switchbacks, it would have taken us right up here. But we decided to get off the switchbacks. But that's okay. We needed to give our body a rest after 4 miles when we thought it was originally only going to be a mile. Boy, were we wrong. But yeah, Fort Dickerson linking with other hills south of the river. This Union position was a major factor in the defense of Knoxville, occupied November 1st, 1863. There's some picnic spots up here. Again, no bathrooms. But this is it right here. I mean, you would come up here and be all like, that's a fort. But really, remember that a fort is anything that's just a high ground. And the Civil War is, we've kind of showed in some of our Gettysburg videos, what's left of Civil War forts. This is about it. They're not, you know, like a castle structure like you would think of a fort being. Oh, but we found the cannons. Dry ditch.
Yeah, could you imagine carrying the artillery from Tennessee River to here?
Oh my gosh, yeah, seriously, because that's what they would have done. They would have carried the artillery from the... Yeah. So these markings kind of map out exactly what parts of the fort would have been here. Perfect spot for a sniper and the artillery cannon. This actually is a really good fortified location. The gun embrasure. Another artillery cannon over here. So at this park, there is a Civil War historic site. Here's the Underground Magazine right here. There is mountain biking trails with switchbacks. There's a huge quarry, and a little over about 4 miles of hiking trails, all within Knoxville, Tennessee. We're really liking this runcation so far. It's absolutely beautiful. And with that, Run 50 States My Way, it's Ashley and Ryan. Whew, we've had a great morning. Now we're off to find some lunch, which is gonna be downtown, probably along Market Square. So stay tuned for that. With that, adventure awaits 1 mile at a time. Like, subscribe, and comment down below. And most importantly, thanks for watching as we explored Fort Dickerson Park here in Knoxville.